And he was like, what do you think about Obama? I was like, who's Obama? And he's like, he's a guy, the black guy's running for president. And I didn't know much about him. And I was like, what are you talking about? His name's Hussein Obama. I said, why don't you make his name Gaddafi or Castro or something? You know, this is a joke. I actually run for president. And then I went home and saw him on YouTube, and I was hooked ever since. So this is funny to me. When I talk, I'm really talking to myself. Because it's like you enter my world on YouTube. I'm not entering your world. But if you like my world, that's cool. If you don't, watch something else. But my point is, I remember my ex-girlfriend was Russian, and we was having sex. And I drank the Kool-Aid too much on Obama. And we were having sex one time, and I mentioned during an intimacy. I said, you know what? Obama parents are interracial too, Natasha. And she looked at me during middle sex like, why am I with you? That just loves this funny, you know? But anyway, I'm wearing a Prince shirt, and this is another highlight of my life. I was a Prince fanatic. I was in Job Corps, and I used to wear a purple scarf over my eye. And at that time, Purple Rain was just came out. I was I was mesmerized by Prince. And then in Job Corps, I did really good. It's very hard to go advanced training in Job Corps. It takes too long to explain. But it's maybe 1 out of 1,000 people in Job Corps can go to advanced training. I got accepted in advanced training in Minneapolis when Purple Rain was just in theaters. So it's like a fantasy. And then the girl I met in the club was named Lydia, I won't say her last name. But anyway, she was a singer herself. Her former boyfriend was named Andre Simone, who's a singer. That was Prince's best friend. Prince lived with him when he left home, you know, with problems. Anyway, and then I remember I was sitting hanging out with Lydia. She was 20 years old, had a brand new car. She had a waterbed, her own apartment. And I remember one time she was singing in a hotel, like 50 people, right? And she could really sing. She was like black and Hawaiian. So I was driving, I was 21 then. And she was driving the car, and then we went back to her place. And after I was so mesmerized, because I remember Will Smith, I knew him. I'm going to get to that next. And I remember Lydia, and after she sang from 50 people, we went back to the apartment. We had sex for like 2 hours. I'm like, whoa. It just brings back memories for me. Anyway, so I mentioned Will Smith, and that I talked about him like, oh my God, I can't believe that's the same effing person. I remember his name was Willard. And this is the story. That is my favorite story. I've been talking about him every, oh my God. But I played basketball with him as a kid. I was 13, he was 8. He went to Our Lady of Lourdes with my sister. So what he did was, somehow, he was always energetic. He was never nerdy, he was confident, but he never looking like he's gonna be some superstar. But anyway, so he went to Our Lady of Lourdes. Somehow my sister was scared to go to school. And my dad, he's like 6'1", big. He grew up, he's the only black family in the white township, so he fought a lot. He was not the type of person. He wasn't street, he wasn't ghetto, but he was really like, he could fight. So anyway, he was very upset. So he asked my stepmom, why can't Michelle go to school? And she said, she's scared. So she found, this is the story, this is what my dad told me. So Willard, not Fresh Prince, not Men in Black, Willard, at 8 years old, was sitting on a wall with his friend. And my dad went up to him and said, which one of you is Willard? And Willard goes, who wants to know? And my dad got bad temper. He said, look, I'm going to smack the taste out of your mouth. You tell your daddy, I'm going to come over your house, and I want to know what's going on. You picking on my daughter, I don't appreciate. So he went over to the house, right? This is a true story. I made a video about this. And he went over to the house, and Willard was sitting on the steps of the house. And Will Smith's dad came to the door, and my dad was polite. He said, listen, your son's picking on my daughter. I don't appreciate it. Blah, blah, blah. And Willard said something. And this is what my dad told me. He said he went to the house, and he said, listen, I will whip your ass. I don't want to cuss, but he said, I whip your dad. That's what he said. And then and I guess Will Smith's dad didn't want to have no problem. So he said, sir, this won't be no problem. He wasn't scared enough, but he was like, he didn't want no problem. He was in his house. And my dad told him later, he's like, oh, I shouldn't have done it. He could have shot me or something. You know, so he went in there, and he's walking down the steps. Well, he heard Will Smith crying. His dad, he used to punch his mom, Will Smith's mom. So his dad could be violent. So he heard Will Smith crying, so Will Smith got spanking. So that's legendary now because Will Smith is so famous. But I don't know. I wasn't there. I don't like secondhand information, but because I'm not religious. And that's like 1,000 years ago. But I'm going by what's present day. That's what my dad told me. So I don't know if it happened or it didn't happen. But Will Smith is who Will Smith is. And I always wanted to mention that. And I had a dream one time, right, that I never knew he was going to be that famous. I thought, like, if I went back in time, and I was like, I know what he's going to turn out to be, I'd try to be super cool with him. And I realized it's my own way of explaining it. I was going to talk to him, like, hey, like, subconsciously, like, man, it's so hot out here. It's like summertime, you know what I mean? Or I would say something like, guy walking down the street, wow, look at this guy, man in black suit, you know? I would say stuff, like, ahead of time, like, it would inspire him when he was a kid, but that would... that it'd be weird. I can imagine him going back to his dad and like, oh my God, you know Michelle's brother? You know, he said this, like, black men, and they go down Miami in summertime, and you want to get jiggy with it. You know what I'm saying? I'm making this up on my own, you know. And I'm like, that would backfire because he was telling his dad, and dad was like, you leave that family alone. The father's a psychopath, the sister's insensitive, and the brother's a weirdo. So I'm just, that never happened. I'm just imagining. So anyway, I'm ending the video on that. Today, Harvey Silver, 9 years she died. I don't know if it's afterlife or not. I don't think energy dies. You're top of my list, and my cat is. And if people like it, what I'm saying, that's cool. You know, I'm speaking from my heart. I've seen so much stuff, and I'm not picking on you, Mo, but I remember one time you said something, and you made me think, like, my videos, the lighting could be better, the editing could be better, and they could, because I did it on a smartphone, a lot of them I did spontaneous. But I also realized, too, I watch YouTube every day for hours. My videos were good enough to go viral. It's not so much the lighting and editing, which could be better, but it's a storyline. And that's way more important than stuff that's so popular on YouTube. So I'm actually saying from my heart. And that's the most honest, best thing with acting. I've been on, like, I worked on 40 movies. I worked on 40 TV shows and blah, blah, blah. I met so many celebrities. And the best thing about acting is, it's not so much you acting. You really are being yourself. You're speaking, because you can't lie in front of the camera. Like, I'm not lying in front of you. Everything I'm saying, it happened. And same thing was in front of the TV cameras. And Harvey, this one thing about Harvey I love. He's told me one time, if you could do it in front of the public, you could do it in front of the cameras. And the stuff he did, he was like, the audience was the public. Like, when I walk out with him, it's like hanging out with Will Smith or Tupac or any famous person. Because he had that type of energy. And that's all it comes down to. So anyway, Harvey, you're my brother. I love you. And I wish I could see you now, but I can't. You've been dead 9 years. And my pet, Star, what people think, people love them, animals, people don't. It doesn't really matter. She meant a lot to me, too. So anyway, thank you, Mo, for doing this. And you can end it now.